First of all, what is pragmatism? Pragmatism is an educational philosophy based on interactive learning experiences used to enhance student learning and to deviate from the traditional school system in previous years. Pragmatism is mainly used in science-based subjects such as physics and biology. It is, however, subject to change, provided that the results differentiate from previous outcomes.
Lend me your heart and I'll just let you fall. Lend me your eyes, I can change what you...
John Dewey had received his PhD in philosophy from Johns Hopkins University. He then founded his now famous laboratory school located at the University of Chicago in 1896. John Dewey had a certain perception of pragmatism, which he referred to as instrumentalism. Instrumentalism is a view that knowledge comes from the linking together of events. Inquiry requires an active participation in such processes. Dewey's advocation of pragmatism had led to a new philosophical idea, progressivism. Dewey developed his ideas from Pestalozzi, James, and Froebel.
As quoted by William James, it is true if it satisfies, is verifiable, and verified in experience. James believed that an idea could be considered true if it works in practice. An idea has meaning only if a person believes the idea is true, resulting in him behaving differently. An idea is true if it benefits us in real life. James was influenced by science and religion. Testing for truth is independent of fact and dependent on human thought.
You invest your life in these bodies, we will live.
Charles Sanders Peirce is credited with the first idea of pragmatism. However, William James, who is now considered the father of pragmatism, made modifications Peirce did not agree with. James's version of pragmatism is referred to as New Pragmatism and is the most popular idea among philosophers today. One of pragmatism's pedagogies is lecture. In the case of a science course, a lecture takes place to provide students with information. We need lectures because students' reasoning is not adequately developed when subject matter is presented only by textbook. Although lectures are a great way to efficiently use time and energy, it exists merely as a way of dealing with material. Even by lecture, knowledge is secondhand and verbal, which lacks meaning.
Another pedagogy consists of labs. One way to learn is by using observations that can come from doing a lab of the material learned in the lecture. Experiencing material firsthand and coming up with the same results as what was taught in lecture is a great way for a student to observe what they have been lectured about. Instead of just learning to memorize science, a student now learns a scientific way of treating familiar material in ordinary experiences.
Recitation can also serve as a time to discuss results of the lab. Students can get a better understanding of the material by listening to other students' observations from their own experiment. In this way, the student can hear someone else's interpretation of the lab and gain a better understanding of the material by seeing it from other points of view.
Pragmatism's influence on education can still be seen to this day. Whether it be a lecture of 200 students at a university or a lab for a high school science class, pragmatism continues to have a profound impact on education.